anybody here? Tell me. Hey, Komula. So, I'm just filing my flight plan. Also Burgop, Victor, Quebec, Papa Romeo, estimate unroad time, well, I don't know, half an hour, fuel on board, 1 hour 30, alternate, Kathmandu, no alternate. Remark, send. So. Let's see, who else is here? Somebody's on approach, 6 miles out. There we go. Some Turkish is here in the descent or in the climb out. Let's see. He's climbing. And this Philippine Airlines, he's on final approach. Oh, we should be able to see this guy shortly. Coming around the corner here. He's just 2 miles out. Where is he? Okay, let's do the following. We go to Philippine and we go to display. Come on. Follow in simulator. There he is. There he is. So. Let's see what he's doing. Oh, he's landing from the south. Hi, Kirsten. This guy is landed von Süden her. Aber wir haben doch Wind, der hat doch Rückenwind bestimmt, oder? Oh, er ist gecrashed. Wetten? Der ist gecrashed. Ah, doch nicht. Okay, das war nur Netzwerkaussetzer. Ja, genau. Landet in der Mitte von der Bahn. Oh, come on. Durchstarten, durchstarten. Mal gucken, ob es reicht, um zu bremsen. Ich bin gespannt. Also. Oh oh. Aha. Mein Swift hat es zerlegt. Krass. Aha. Mal gucken, ob ich das nochmal. Ob ich das reproduzieren kann. Also, connect. ATC. Ja. Das kann man reproduzieren. So, kann ich das hier rüber machen und sagen Sprint Screen. Dann muss ich hier mein Grafikprogramm nehmen. Und dann mache ich einfügen als neues Bild. Ausschneiden. Abspeichern. Weg. Okay, nochmal. Ich glaube, ich muss noch den. Oh, come on. Ich will vor allem wissen, hat er es geschafft oder nicht? Oder liegt er in der Botanik? Schnell connecten. Ja, nicht Chaos Tag. Swift hat sich abgeschossen. So, wo ist denn jetzt der? So, Connect to Watsim. Mal gucken. Mal gucken, ob es der Philippinen Airlines geschafft hat oder ob er hinten in den Büschen liegt. Er ist nicht mehr online. Ich vermute, ihn hat es hinten rausgetragen. Ah ne, da ist er wieder. Philippine Airlines. Da ist er. Steht auf der Bahn allerdings. So. Jetzt will ich nochmal hier das versuchen nachzuvollziehen. Also erstmal VQPR. Wetter anfordern. 130 Grad, 13 Knoten. Ja, das ist Rückenwind. Da geht man nicht rein so. Warum macht er sowas? Okay. So. Jetzt muss ich hier machen. Einfügen das neues Bild. Ach nee, nochmal. Scheiße. Jetzt mache ich jetzt hier die ExtensionView-Version vom Bildschirm. Shot. Also, Swift-GUI. Das ist ein neuer Bug. Ja, bring mir den Müll runter, ja. Ich brauche noch kurz hier. Ich will diesen Bug noch schnell reproduzieren und dokumentieren. Okay. Online sowie offline. Passiert das? Also Flugplan neu eingeben, Altitude 60.000, 16.000, 16.000, ah, was haben wir hier? Route, was war das? Bogop, glaube ich, ne? Ja, Bogop. Und wir gehen zurück. VQPR, Onroute Time 30 Minuten, Fuel 1 Stunde 30, kein Alternate, Remarks, ja, loaded, Anna, erstmal hier Connect to WATSIM, Flight Plan sent, nochmal zur Sicherheit, dann Unicom. Und Swift weg. So. Check this go away. So, we need ground services. GPU connect. Start flight lag. Let's put in a bit of payload. 10 tons. It's fine. I'll make it 9 tons. 9 tons. Ja. Und Fuel of 4 tons. Refuel. Keep this page. And we need two. Battery. Ground power. Emergency lights armed. IRS nav and nav. That was a bit too far. Yaw damper on. Window heat on. Electric pumps on. What else? We need a fuel pump. Oh no. Today we do a external power, external air source startup. So, no APU. You want to test something. Alright, so. Also, Weg to Quebec, Papa Romeo, Paro. Copy, paste, route, stop, copy, paste, runway, what did we say, 15 for takeoff, for departure, and let's do it this way, yeah, this is done, and we insert the arrival, via RNF Zulu 15, Bogop, oh, 1 Alpha or 1 Bravo. Oh. So. Fuel is finished. 19.5. I hope I can remember this. Charts. Come here. No, that was the wrong one. We need Paro. Bogop 1 Alpha we need. Okay, Bogop 1 Alpha. Have a look. Yeah, Bogop. And for departure, I will insert some waypoints. And I'm gonna use the waypoints from the missed approach of the approach that we are going to use. Of the RMP Zulu 15. And we're gonna use these waypoints here. So Papa Romeo 706 and 710. Ooh. So I copy this to shorten 706, then 710, so I don't have to type everything, I just have to modify the digits, so I just copy them, then 712, 714, 714, then, hi Stone, welcome back. 746 and 848. 746, 848. I hope I can remember that. So, 746. Oh, I'm stupid. It's down here. And 848. And then Papa Romeo 777. So we do now, as you can see on the charts at the moment, here, you see, oh, you can't see it here. So you see the approach from Bogop goes to 782, 780 and 777, 16,000 feet. And incidentally, the approach will start as well from 777. So I will insert the holding there. We're gonna make one entry, return, and then we're gonna fly the approach. I don't wanna fly all the way to Bogop and come back and this kind of stuff. No, we don't do this. So Papa Romeo 777, where are you? Nowhere. Okay, let's do it. Activate this. So 746 and then. So from 777 it's 848-830. 848-830. Okay, there we go. So we need 846, so we need 777. Still. And we say hold. At 777, and we said it is it's here, so it's 354 degrees right turns, so exactly the opposite to what it is suggesting here. 354 degrees, but right turns are fine. 1.5 minute lag time. So, but we will just fly the entry, come back to the waypoint, and then we're gonna leave the holding again. All right. And you can as well. Does it work? Yeah, it does. Yeah, there we go. Cool. So we got these points. And let's have a look again. So after 777 we have to go back to 848 and 830. I wonder if I now insert 848 here again, will it? Yeah, it is. And if I create the point, will it again try to bring these two together or not? Ah, now it works, yeah. Okay. I cannot copy it, I have to create the point new. I have to type it and then it works. Alright. Cool. That was the mistake in my previous attempt. Now, performance. 52.1, yeah, that sounds good. 4 tons of fuel, sounds good. Reserves, what did we say? 2.5, I think it was. Cost index, 50. And we're gonna climb to 16,000. Transition altitude is 18,000. So why is it saying flight level 100? It shouldn't. Zack. Well, we will definitely not derate here. And we're gonna as well climb at full power. And we can try a flap 15 takeoff. I've never done that, I have to admit. The CG is 19.5, though the trim is 4.25. Again, it's yeah, doing stupid things with the reverse. Ah, computers. So there's nothing useful here.
We go. Sie haben neue Post, ne?
We go here, that's good. Anything else? I'm sure I forgot something. Well, let's go for this chart here. So we climb steepest angle available, 16,000 along the waypoints. Terrain here, all random, all higher than me. Alright, so let's get going. So we need first fuel pumps. That's all good. APU bleed off, pack bleed off, and isolation valve override. Oh yeah, QNH is a good idea. So we said the QNH is 1018, I think. Let me request it again. Victor, Quebec, Papa Romeo. Yeah, 130 degrees, 14 knots. That's good for runway 15. Scattered clouds at 3000 feet. So with this elevation of 7400, that's about 10,400 feet. That's just above the minimum. And I think it's not a coincidence that they're reporting 3,000 feet. Probably it's lower in the real world, but they're reporting a higher ceiling so they don't preclude the operators from at least trying the approach. And broken 9,000 feet. So 9,000 is about 16,000 something feet, that's fine. Temperatures 20 and QNH 1018, indeed. So we need a flight director. I call for pushback.
Ground to cockpit. Tow is driving up.
We take LNAV. Oh no, we can't use LNAV for some reason. Probably because we made up the points. So we use heading select and VNAV and 131 on the V2. But once we're airborne, we can try with LNAV. Now, we have to ask for our external air supply. So we use the ASU, stands for Air Starter Unit. Air Starter Unit. Which is here now. It's this box here.
No? Okay, all doors and hatches are closed. Ready to connect.
Differently. Have you done this already? So you see here this hose that the pushback truck just drove onto is connected to here, a port under the belly of the aircraft. And now there's a little turbine in there, like an APU, and it's now generating bleed air for us to use to spin one engine. We start one engine, we're gonna start the left engine in this case, so they can work safely on the right side of the aircraft. And once the engine is started, we will disconnect the we're gonna disconnect the air starter unit, we're gonna connect as well the engine generator, and then we can disconnect the ground power unit too. And then we can start the other engine with the help of the running engine already. So, let's have a look. So, we have duct pressure, so it should work. Let's have a look if we can. Maybe we should as well turn on the anti-collision light. And oh no, I'm on the wrong engine. I'm stupid. Oops. Stop.
Flight attendants, prepare for departure. Cross check and all call. Thank you.
We want to start the left engine. Very unusual. So, start valve open. N2 rotation.
All right, we've got everyone strapped in. Give us a ring if you need anything.
Fuel on. EGT N1 rising. Starter disengaged. Cool. Continuous. So now we said we wanted to connect the engine generator. We have bleed air. Now we ask the ground crew to disconnect the air starter unit and the GPU. And now you see our pressure here in the duct is quite low. We need more pressure. So what we do now probably is we have to... Is the stuff gone? Yeah, it's gone. So we have to increase the engine thrust on the running engine to increase the bleed air pressure. Look, I'm running up the engine a little bit, and there we go, duct pressure goes up. Let's bring it up to 40 psi, and you see we have about 50. Let's put it up to 50% and one, and then we can try to start the right engine. And we have start valve open, N2 rotation. Duct pressure, is it fine? It's falling a little bit. Let's add a bit more thrust. Probably if we looked at the aircraft flight manual of the aircraft, it would tell us, oh, you have to probably set N1 60% or 70% for a good adjust start. So, let's have a look. Starter cutout, we can reduce the thrust slowly on the left engine. There we go. And we set it as normal. We connect the generator. And we can prepare the aircraft here for normal ops. It's fine. And we asked the pushback crew to push
ground
back.
Cockpit, please show me where you want to go. Tow connected and bypass pin and service.
Release
parking brake. Starting pushback.
Yeah, NTIs, I know. I still have to select probe heat on. Do that now. So let's do a final check here. That's all good. That's all good. That's all good. That's all good. We can set the flaps to 15. Speed brake is down. Trim set for takeoff. So, flaps, are they 15? Yes, they are at 15. That's good. Oh, and transponder on, why not? Is anybody else around? Nope, I am the only one.
Operation complete. Set parking brake.
Park brake set.
Disconnecting tow. Stand by.
In the meantime, I can report about the bug. Have a look here, that's the radar I'm using to see if somebody else is around, but you see, not a single aircraft, they all disappeared, they all disconnected.
Tow is disconnected, and bypass bin has been removed, hand signal on the left, we'll see you next time and have a safe flight.
Just a moment, guys. I'll be there right away. I just need to quickly send the crash report. Can remove this window here, let's see, and we can remove the radar again and put it back onto my second screen so you don't have to see it. Alright, so taxi light on, park brake released, let's taxi. Pyro traffic, private air 451, backtracking runway 15 for departure to the south. As usual, I have to start my little joystick software. Otherwise, I can't steer. So, strobe light, landing light on.
Approaching 15.
Yeah, space is clear, there's nobody else around.
On runway 3390 feet remaining.
bit more thrust. Do not come to a standstill. Like on a truck, we have to oversteer a little bit because the nose wheel is so far in the front. The fuselage.
On runway 15.
So there we are. Runway 15. Heading 151. It's runway course. And that's good. Auto throttle is armed. Elapsed time, chronometer. Let's go. Toga. Heading select green, toga green. Check.
V1. V1, routine.
And we go.
Positive read.
Yep, gear up selected, indeed. Not the wrong button like
400.
New Delhi yesterday, or the day before yesterday. Okay, let's fly this visually initially to avoid the hill here, the ridge. So we select flaps 5.
Terrain. 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 Terrain.
Yeah.
Terrain.
We know there's terrain. That's why we're climbing like crazy. So speed check, flaps 1 selected. And let's make it speed intervention 180 knots. To get a steeper angle of climb out of this. And let's try LNAV. Autopilot, command green, LNAV, VNAV speed. With a manual, speed intervention. 10,000 feet. Taxi light, landing light off. Temperature is plus 15, so we don't need anti-ice just yet. So you see, this is the missed approach path. For runway 15. Scary shit. Well, we can try to accelerate to minimum clean and remove the flaps. That will give us a slightly steeper angle. But in the meantime, we are trading a little bit. Speed, altitude for speed. We could be higher at the same time. Up to now. But then we're gonna climb steeper afterwards. Speed check, flaps up selected. Okay, auto brake 3 already for our next approach. I'm setting the minimum for the next, before the approach that we're going to fly soon, so 10,200 feet, I think it was. Takes a while. So there we are. So you can see here we are approaching these points, Papa Romeo 777 with the holding, so we're expecting a holding entry. And then after the holding entry has been flown, probably it's going to fly a parallel entry, it's going to fly like this, and then back to Papa Romeo 777. And then I'm going to exit the hold, and we're going to follow these waypoints to fly the approach. And just to remind us of how to fly the approach, so after Papa Romeo 777, we fly to 848-830-828-826-728-730-799-818-816. At 816 we have to be at 13,800, and there are no minimum altitudes given here as far as I can see. Here, 13.8 up to here. There's nothing written here. Very interesting. We're gonna maintain 16,000 as long as possible. Minimum, yeah. 10,320 is the minimum actually. So I'm gonna correct that now. Yeah, scary mountains. So, holding entry. Reset the chronometer. Mount Everest, yeah. Yeah, well, I see Mount Cumulus, but not Mount Everest here. Okay, there we go. Left turn, back inbound to Papa Romeo 777. And the chart said to cross Papa Romeo 777 at max 185 knots. Well, we fly 200. I'm gonna reduce later on here. Yeah, missed approach. Well, we just followed the waypoints and we climbed 16,000 feet. Again. Oh, we could possibly get our landing speed set. Yeah, so 129 knots. And I will now press exit hold, execute, and now we should follow all those fantastic points. So again, heading back to runway heading 151. So we have our circuit. Our next point of interest will be here, Papa Romeo 799 at 13,800 or above, it says here. And here it says at 13,800. So I will actually change the entry here from above to at. And as well, I want to have speed 185 / set here 13,800, so the plane should start descent by it, descend by itself at some point in about 4 miles. So let's set the flaps to 5 and use FMC speed. Flaps 5, green light. No, don't trim. Actually, we can tell the thing to already cross this point as well at 185 knots. I want it to slow down now. Doing it? Why? No, not 158. I said 185. Okay, then speed intervention 185 knots. I don't know why it's doing it. Just because of the configuration, really? Well, whatever. So, and we continue at 13.8 until waypoint 816, speed 145. And then again, we have to descend on a 3.5 degree path. Probably if we go steeper, we will collide with mountains here, I don't know. There's not much information given on this chart, sadly. Let's go 180. And I guess the speed restriction is there to avoid overshooting the turns, to stay in the valley or above the valley.
Thousand ago.
So, heute ist nicht so nicht so wolkig wie gestern. Today is not as cloudy as it was yesterday. Yesterday it was really annoying. So, 818 and the next will be 816, isn't it? Yep. So we have to be there at 145 knots, so Let's see, we have about 5 miles to run to reduce the speed. Yeah, we can still wait a little bit before we drop the gear and the flaps. Okay then, 145 knots, gear down, flaps 10, flaps 15, flaps 25, flaps 30, and I'll wait with flaps 40 until we start our final descent. So 10,400, that's for the minimum. And vertical speed 1500 initially, flaps 40. And we reduced the speed to the final speed. We said 129 was our VREF, so let's make it 135. Or we need to arm the speed brake. So we got 7 miles to the runway. In 7 miles we have to be at 6,000 feet lower, so we have to really get our horse down. Yeah, the vertical situation display is only of limited use only. Okay, we are visual, so I will set the altitude select down to 500 feet above the runway, 8,000 feet. But you can only do this when you are visual. Huh? When you IMC, you have to stick to your 3.5 degree path. At least that's how I believe it's done. Oh yeah, maybe landing lights, taxi light, wing light. There's nobody around, so I will not make any calls on Unicom. So at 3 miles from the runway we want to be at 8,600 roughly.
Yep. Minimums.
Contact, continue. Saying we are about 400 feet above the optimum glide path to the runway at 3.5. 3 miles and we are about 600 feet high here, it says. Well, let's go manual. Autopilot off, auto throttle off. If we go around, climb along the VNAV point to 16,000 feet. Flight director is off on my side. So the runway will be around the corner here. And it says we only have 1.5 miles to the runway. Oh, the speed is a bit low. I have to correct. Correcting. Okay. There's the runway.
Approaching. One. Cool. Five.
So that works, yeah. But it's really annoying that you cannot see the runway until you pass this ridge here. You just can't see the runway and you have to rely on
Caution, taxiway. Caution, taxiway.
Yeah, taxiway, my ass. But we're still high.
Approaching 1-5.
Sink rate. Sink rate. Pull up. Pull up.
Yeah, sink rate. I should go around.
100. Pull up. Pull up. 50, 40, 30, 10.
You're floating. Manual brake.
80
so
miles.
The visual illusion here is quite severe. So I was on the right path, but then I made a mistake. I pulled up the nose a little bit and we ended up high. What a shame. We're gonna replay, but first I will go to the parking.
Forward to welcoming you again on another flight.
I will lock off from VATSIM and then we can do that.
On runway 33.
Alright, heating off. We leave these on. We're gonna fly more, don't worry, of course. Strobe off, landing lights off. APU on. Park brake. APU connected, fuel off. Bleed, override. Electric off, taxi light beacon off. Fuel pumps off. And transponder off. Now, disconnect from VATSIM and you say F to control arm. No? Control R doesn't do anything. Flight replay, where is it? I never tried that. Where is it? Where can I replay? Wo kann ich denn replay machen? Alt R. Ah ja, there we go. Ah, hier. Aber wo im Menü? Ich sehe es nicht. Ah, hier. Toggle Replay Mode. Okay. So, hier war alles in Ordnung. Everything was fine here. Let me just do one thing. Pause the thing. I want to quickly. Oh, I can't. Okay, I can't do anything. Okay, then let's continue. I thought I could insert the runway, but I cannot do anything on the cockpit here. So here I did a bit of a level off, or I reduced the rate of descent too much. That was a mistake. I should have continued down, but it looked too low. It just looked too low here. So, jetzt kommt gleich die Bahn in Sicht. Da ist die Bahn. Da muss man früher um die Kurve rum, hätte ich Sekunde früher drehen müssen. Und Sinkrate beibehalten. Jetzt habe ich Sinkrate reduziert, ja, weil ich Angst habe vor der vor dem Hügel. I was a bit afraid or worried about the ridge, so I reduced the rate of descent. That was a mistake. Now I should have increased the rate of descent again much earlier. See, and now we are ending up high. Now we are too high.
300.
Wow, 2.5 touchdowns. Also real wäre das Go-Around gewesen, keine Frage. Unstable, Go-Around, try it again. Eben, da kann man tiefer drüber. Wahrscheinlich muss man noch ein bisschen nach links ins Tal hinein, dass man mehr Abstand hat zum Berg. Dann kann man tiefer drüber fliegen. Wir wollen ja nicht für Turkish Airlines fliegen. Die machen dann sowas. Oh, go for it. Ja, ja, la, la. Ryanair-Landung. Bunk. Sehr gut. Ja, als Passagier würde ich mir dann die Hose machen, dauernd. So, one more time. From this perspective. Und dann ist gut. Dann haben. Obwohl, ne, wir können noch. Haben wir noch. Wir haben einen Tower View, glaube ich, ne? Wo ist denn der? Ja, hier. Da kommen wir. Um die Kurve rum. Ja, eben, da war noch genügend Luft zum Berg, da hätte man tiefer reinfliegen können. Und dann waren wir unstable, zu hoch. Doinks. Und auch jetzt haben wir schon durchstarten müssen. Doinks. Doink. Aber eben, daraus lernt man halt. Deswegen übt man sowas im Simulator und nicht im echten Flugzeug. Dass man solche Fehler machen kann, davon lernt. Und dann kann man es im richtigen Flugzeug besser tun, besser machen. So, ist der Kathmandu-Freund noch da? Ne, der ist weg. Inzwischen hat sie ausgelockt. Oh ja, ist da wieder. Seit 5 Stunden 50 ist er schon da, der Brody. Krass. Die Australier machen auch gerade zu. Europa, oh, da sind einige unterwegs, die ich kenne angeblich. Ah, den Adria-Sektor will ich noch machen, das mache ich später. Wer fliegt der Atlantik? Oh ja, lang nicht mehr gesehen. Also, tschüss. Da sind wir. Also, was haben wir gesagt? Wir wollen nach Kathmandu. Da muss ich erst einmal machen hier ein neues Fenster. Simbrief. Wir brauchen den Simbrief Loader. New Flight. Also von, wir sind was? Private Air 451 Tom Cooper Air nach VNKT. Wo ist denn VILK? Ja, die 33 ist einfacher. Finde ich. Wo ist denn VILK? Ach so, Lucknow. Okay. Sind wir hier 4000 Haze und hier haben wir 3000. Was ist denn DS? Dry Snow? Sicherlich nicht. Bei 30 Grad plus. Becoming Thunderstorm and Rain. Ne, wir nehmen den nächsten. Wir nehmen den Patna. VEPT. Was haben wir noch? Varanasi. Der ist besser sogar. Also VEBN. Sibum. Wir geben Vollgas. Flugzeit 1 Stunde voraussichtlich. Departure Runway 02, Taxi out 4 Minuten, Taxi in 5, 4 Minuten, extra Fuel 15 Minuten. Und wir wollen nicht so schwer sein, machen wir hier ungefähr 53 Tonnen. So, man hier Paro. Dann generate flight plan, yes. Genau. Tour Guide. Aber Level 360 ist viel zu hoch. Das muss ich mal noch neu rechnen hier. Edit. Wir machen hier Altitude, Flight Level 300. Ja, höher gehen wir nicht. So, was haben wir hier? Fuel brauchen wir 6,3 Tonnen. Oh, ganz schön schwer. Den können wir da einschalten. Also. Das ist gut so. Home. Zack, zack. Erstmal tanken. 6,3 Tonnen. Fuel. Fuel Truck Call. Fuel kommt. Payload. Tonnen. So, was soll uns geben? Zero Fuel Rate 53,4 ungefähr. Also VQPR VNKT, aber ich muss zuerst den Flugplan rauslassen auch. Moment, hier, Simbrief Downloader. Ja, weg. Company Route, da ist er. Ja. Paro Kimti, ja, bei Golf 438, that's good. Activate, execute, Runway 15. Performance Init, ja, 53,3 stimmt. Fuel 6,3. Planned Fuel. Flight Level 300 for Cruise. Still fueling. Then Alternate Fuel 2 tons plus 1.1 is 3.1 ton reserves. Cost Index 85. And Wind 28231. ISA deviation plus 12. Execute, ja, yeah, using reserve fuel, genau. Aber es stimmt noch alles gar nicht, weil wir hier noch, also eben, wir machen ja full steam takeoff. And flaps 15 takeoff. But the speeds are not done yet because we're still refueling. Alright, ich bin mal kurz weg für ein, zwei Minuten. So, da sind wir wieder. Also. Oh. Transponder alt off. Oh, we're not alone. The Philippine Airlines guy is back. Next to us, probably. Yep, there he is. So, FMC, so we got the correct takeoff mass, 53 plus 6 is 59, that's good. Yep, no derating. Oh, we need the CG, 20.2. Trim, 4.25. V speeds 135 on the V2. There we go. Flight director on. And what's our flight plan? Yeah, well, not really. Also, wir machen das wieder wie vorhin. Wir tragen wieder die Wegpunkte ein aus diesem Mist Approach, um aus dem Tal rauszukommen. Und sobald wir auf 16.000 sind, drehen wir rüber zum ersten Wegpunkt der Route. Also, Papa Romeo 706. Dann 7:10, 12:14. Seven, four, six. Und dann Papa Romeo, let's go direct to 777. Und dann Subsu. So, how does it look like on our plan mode? Yeah, looking good. I like. So auto brake, RTO. Overhead panel is ready for startup. Beacon on, fasten belts on, fuel pumps on. Request pushback.
Ground cockpit, tow is driving up. Ground cockpit, please show me where you want to go.
Und Q&A schon mal gesagt, 1018, ne? 18, da hat sich verstellt. Paro Traffic, Private Air 451 will be pushing back shortly. Departure runway 15. Ist der auch auf 1228, der Filipino? Ja, ist er.
Okay, all doors and hatches are closed. Gucken, ready to connect.
Der fliegt. Was? VNLK. Lukla? Ey, das kann nicht sein. Aber eben hier das. Das ist immer noch nicht funktionell mit meinem Pushback View. Geht das bei euch mit der neuesten Version vom Better Pushback? Dass man das mit der Maus bewegen kann noch, mit der linken Maus? Weil bei mir geht es nicht mehr. Mit der vorherigen Version funktionierte es, mit der neuesten geht es nicht mehr. Okay, park brake release, let's go.
Starting pushback. And you may start engines.
Okay, warum hat er sich umgedreht jetzt? Wir wollen noch. Genau. Wir wollen nicht vorwärts fahren. Alright then, starting engine number 2. Valve open, N2 rising. Wir prüfen mal, dass unser Flugplan durchgegangen ist. Fuel on. Ja, ging durch. Ja, das ist unsere Route. Eben, Lukla kennt er gar nicht. Der will ja wohl nicht mit seinem A320 nach Lukla fliegen, das ist doch Schwachsinn. Aber ich habe schon viel erlebt hier, deswegen. Whatever, wenn es ihm Spaß macht. Starting Engine Number 1.
Operation complete. Set parking brake.
Fuel on. Park brake set.
Disconnecting tow. Stand by.
Oh, ich habe eine Airline morgen
so
nach Amsterdam.
Bypass, then has been removed. Hand signal on the left.
8:30 we'll see you next time and have a safe flight. Zug um 6 Uhr nehmen. Schön. Aber ich darf fliegen gehen vielleicht. Hey. Warum nicht? Also, dann machen wir jetzt hier Flaps 5, 10, 15 selected. Generators, APU off, probe heat, PAX and valve auto, APU off, cruising level 300. Und was war die Elevation von Kathmandu irgendwie, ne? 5000, 4000, irgendwas, 600, 800, naja, ist gut genug. So, taxi light on, let's go. Paro Traffic, Private Air 451, taxiing, backtracking, runway 15. So, we have flaps 15, green light, auto brake RTO, speed brake down, flap as I trim 4.25 set. Transponder, Tara, code 2000. We have heading select and vertical speed green and VNAV armed. Probably when we select Toga, mal probieren. What happens if I select Toga now? Yeah, Toga is green now. Yeah, that's good. But I fear that it will cause the auto throttle, the throttles to go to full steam as soon as I arm the auto throttle. Okay, landing lights, strobe lights on.
Approaching 15.
Oh, es regnet bei uns real.
On runway
nicht im
3, 900 feet remaining.
man den Regen hören am Fenster? Im Stream? Wahrscheinlich schon, ne? Dicke Tropfen. Ja, das ist hier konvektives Wetter. Oh, ich muss mal kurz prüfen. Ich glaube, ich habe noch ein Fenster offen. Sekunde. Weiter geht's. Vor allem, was sich wundert, es hat noch keiner Paro schön gemacht. Es ist okay, die Szenerie, aber das kann man noch viel, viel schöner machen, bestimmt. Dass das keiner kommerziell macht, verstehe ich nicht. Ich weiß, die Stückzahlen wären nicht hoch genug im Verkauf, lohnt sich nicht und bla bla bla. Aber das wäre zumindest eine gute Demonstration der Szeneriebaukünste. Why hasn't... Sorry, I switched to German. Also, I'm wondering why no payware... has been made for Paro, at least not for X-Plane, because it's nice, it's okay here, the standard scenery, but it could be much nicer, especially the roads and the terrain.
On runway,
could
one,
be more accurate.
Five.
I know, there wouldn't be enough scenery sold, so that's it. So let's see. We said we have Toga already activated. Now, if I now select auto throttle on arm, let's see if it will advance these thrust levers or not. Yeah, it is. Yeah. Alright, elapsed time. Brake holding the brake. We do a static takeoff. Okay, brake released, auto throttle armed. N1 at 80 knots, it will change to throttle hold.
80 knots.
Checked. Yeah, FSX, well, that's like 20 years ago. So, rotate, let's go! Now we are a bit heavier than before. Gear up. Okay, we do speed intervention, we stay at 160. I want to have a steep climb out of here. Let's try LNAV, let's see where it will guide us to. But I'm flying visually, so at the moment I'm disregarding the horizontal input, lateral input of the flight director. I'm flying here manually to avoid the CTED. Flaps 10. Staying in the valley. Pyro traffic, private air 451 is airborne, climbing level 300 towards the southeast. Southwest. Speed check, flaps 5 selected, we need a few more knots to be on the good side. Bumpy here. staying out of the clouds here, so I'm staying visual. I'm not following the flight director completely. Okay, I'm going back to the LNAV path here. Which will make us stay inside the valley, or the center, above the center of the valley. That's what we want. Wow, it's really raining now here. Okay, now we can clean up the bird. Reverting to standard VNAV speeds to clean up the plane. Speed check, flaps 1 selected. Flaps up. Well, autopilot, command green, LNAV and VNAV speed. We have flaps up, light out, auto brake off, gear up and off. We're climbing to a flight level, standard set. Taxi light off, ignition auto. Then we can release the seat belts, wing light off. We fly to Supsu. We're almost at 16,000 feet, so we're fine. So we can accept this turn. Wow, this rain is really bad here. Let's have a look. So, Mr. Fliesenmann, oh yeah, look at the temperature difference. So at the moment we are having this blob of weather here, this cell. Ah, it intensified. It intensified here above the city. So that's it. The sky is already brightening up again, so we're almost done with the weather. And here have a look for the weather. Huh? It's cold here. I see here over there where Kirsten lives in this area. It's 11, 12 degrees, and we still have 18. That's 23 here along the Rhine River in the valley. But I wonder what's happening here. Is this just here convective weather, or is it a cold front? No, I think it's convective weather, not a front. Frontal system now. by the way, that's our flight path. Oh yeah, I like here the VFR charts. You can really see the massive size of the Himalayas. It's unbelievable how much rock stone has been uplifted by the Indian continent crashing into Eurasia. It's incredible. So I think, if I remember correctly, the depression that the Himalayas have left below the surface is like 50 kilometers. That's why it, on Earth, with our gravity, factor of gravity, I think mountains cannot become higher than about 10,000 meters, 30,000 feet, 31,000 feet, because of their own mass, because they just sink in slowly. It cannot be upheld. So let's get ready for ATC 124.7. And I think we have to call them at SUPSA, don't we? Let's have a look. So that's what I like here, these maps. Just click here on FIR and it will show the FIR border. Hopefully. Not. There we go. So it takes a while. Okay, Kathmandu is at Metom. So I'm gonna call them here at Bravo Golf Delta. I'm gonna call Kathmandu. And Bravo Golf Delta is not far away. It's here, we're gonna be there. Bravo at 10:43 Z on our internal clock, and it's 10:38, so essentially in 5 minutes we're gonna call Kathmandu control. Let's start preparing our approach into Kathmandu. There's one approach here from Dolal, but we're arriving via Kimpti. Ah, yeah, Kimpti, that's the one we need. Kimpti 1 Romeo to Munal, Ratan, and that's for the RMP arrival. And today we fly, at least so far, I don't want to be too optimistic, so far the my FMC has not crashed. So we can attempt to today to fly this approach here, and not the VUR DME, the VUR approach I mean. Ratan, Gouras, and then down the valley. Angle 2.8 degrees. So let's set this up on the FMS. So RNF 02. Via Ratan and Kimpti 1 Romeo arrival. Let's see, Kimpti 646-644, Munal 642-640, Ratan, Gouras. Let's change this to 10,500 at, not above. So we have a chance to slow down as well. And then Gouras 532, speed 200 knots or less or below. Then KT 530, 87, and then we start our descent. We'll find this from 71. Well, let's look at the map, it's easier. So Gouras, KT 532, and the final approach point or fix is KT 530. Okay, it's this one here. So max 170 knots there. 5:30. 170 maximum. Okay. Here it's saying 153, so the condition is fulfilled. So 87, 8 to 40, 71 at Dauphin, 867, 40, 6 to 60, 5 to 80. And then at here at KT 520 and 814, that's when we go visual. Minimum 4621. Kathmandu Center, hello. It's private air 451 at Bravo Golf Delta. It's level 300 now. I'm sure I said it as well. Come on, Brody, wake up.
Property 451, get in to control. Hello, squawk 2502,
private air 451, and we will request the RMP approach for runway 02. Good. So 2502 set. And the sun is coming out again here at home. Cleared Kim T1 Romeo arrival, when ready to descend level 170, private air 451. So we have the Kathmandu VUR active, and you see we have 170 miles to go to Kathmandu straight line versus 220 miles with all the way around the procedure. Let's do our approach settings here. Let me quickly have a look for the latest weather in Kathmandu. VNKT. VNKT. Oh, come on. VNKT. Meter. There we go. Variable 2 knots, VUE 2021, 1016. So 1016 is preset. Preset. Cool. Hey, guinea pig. Welcome to the mountain madness here. How am I? You can see I'm busy, very busy. Skipping lunch to fly Flight Simulator. Very good, huh? Also, what's our restriction? Upcoming restriction is... Kimpty, 1 Romeo, at or above 170, at or above 12.4, at or above 10.5, at or above 10.5, but I set 10.5 there. Take Rattan fix up here. So we got 130 miles to go to Rattan. To be at 10.5, that's 20,000 feet less, so 20 times 3 is 60 miles. So in about 40 miles, I'm expecting my top of descent. Let's see. Yeah, because we have to fly as well, all the entire arrival. Enough setup, so we need 0 to 2 degrees here, there. Kathmandu 113.20. No food here, only chocolate. Actually, I will get some chocolate more.
Good evening.
Aircraft calling, what airport are you in?
Say again, sir, you're cutting out.
What airport are you in?
Sir, I read 2155.
What departure airport are you at? What airport are you departing? Last station calling, what airport are you at?
Hi Lukas, willkommen.
What departure airport are you at?
Rugby 15.
There's a lot of runway 1, sir. I need to know what airport you're departing. What airport are you currently at? Because I can't give you a clearance if I don't know what airport you're at.
Doesn't know either.
Last station calling. I need to know what departure airport you're at.
Das ist lustig eigentlich, wenn der Pilot nicht weiß, wo er abfliegt. Oder vielleicht weiß er gar nicht, was er sagt, was er von ihm will. Ah, hier. That's funny, eh? When the pilot calling for clearance doesn't know what airport he is departing from. Probably somebody in India somewhere. Let's have a look. Yep, even real life pilot, yeah. Privatjet. Keine Airlines bitte. Aber das wird sich vielleicht ändern. Vielleicht muss ich bald Airline fliegen. Maybe I have to join the airline soon to make money again. Kunming. So, let's see. Activity in Batsim. Ah, here. Tokyo Control is still online. Or online now. Not still. For them it's evening now. So I think it's, they are 7 hours ahead of us. Europe has still Eurocontrol West and Adria Control. Oh, I wanted to as well modify the file to show Adria Center correctly. Well, I haven't done so yet. Ja, sehr gut. Nur zur Zeit keine gute Idee, wie du dir vorstellen kannst. Im Moment werden die alle rausgeworfen. Keiner wird eingestellt. Das in den nächsten 2-3 Jahren wird es auf jeden Fall sehr, sehr viele Hunderte, Tausende super ausgebildete, erfahrene Piloten mit dem richtigen Type Rating geben auf dem Markt. Das wird für Anfänger schwer. Deswegen, wenn du das machen willst, warte noch ein bisschen. Klar, man soll antizyklisch trainieren, also eben, wenn es schlecht läuft, soll man dann Training beginnen, dass man zum Ende der Krise fertig ist und einsteigen kann gleich. Aber mit dieser aktuellen Krise ist ja nicht abzusehen. Es ist überhaupt nicht abzusehen, wann es da mal wieder weitergeht. Also wenn ich jetzt in deiner Lage wäre, gut, ich weiß nicht deine Lage, du bist noch in der Schule oder was? Oder musst noch was? Oder bist du mit Schule fertig? And sorry guys, I'm speaking German. If I should switch to English, please write here on the chat and I'll do so happily, don't worry. I'll do that. Because here the user Lucas, he asked in German like, oh, you're a pilot? Yep, and I'm not, but I would like to become one. Okay, so at the moment he is an apprentice for another job that will take another 2 years. Then Lucas, finish this with the best possible grades and get some experience, because I think 2 years is a good time. So in your shoes, if I were in your shoes, I would continue my apprenticeship or whatever you learn, study, and I think in 2 or 3 years from now it may be again a good point in time to start training. Because it will take you another year, a year and a half to get all your licenses together, and then you may be again able to join in the upgoing, improving market. But nobody can say at the moment at what point in time it's going to be. Yep. So we have about 8 miles to our top of descent, 7 miles, yep. And then we go down, down, down. Oh, actually, what we didn't brief was the mist approach. That may be worth looking at. So mist approach. They want us to climb to 10,500 feet via the RMP mist approach to waypoint Denfi and hold or start a new approach. And actually, what may be interesting to you guys simulating, you see the name of the approach is RMP, Required Navigation Performance, Runway 02 and brackets AR. AR, Alfa Romeo, stands for Authorization Required. So in the real world I wouldn't be allowed to fly this approach because I am not authorized, my company is not authorized. If you want to be authorized, you have to make a special request to the local civil aviation authorities. You have to come up with a training syllabus, and you have to do training in the simulator and computer-based training, you know, documents, briefings, and then you will be allowed to perform this approach. Everybody else has to follow the the VUR runway 02 approach. And the difference is, look here, the descent path is 5.3 degrees, which is quite steep, while the descent path for the authorization required approach, the RMP approach, is only 2.8 degrees, so it's much easier to fly in terms of energy control in the descent. Oh yeah, I want to have a look at the points. So runway 02, then KT 590, 592. Let's have a look. 590, 592, 812. 812, max 220 knots. Then 814, 7,500 feet. Yep. But here it's saying at 7,500. Well, 914. Yep, dark. Then 890, 892, 894, 896, 898, 898. Yeah, it's here, and then it should be Denfi with a holding at 10,500. Yeah. So we can follow the missed approach on LNAV. Private Air 451 is in the descent for level 170.
Private Air 451.
Okay, QNH 1016, we descend via the arrival to 10,500 feet for RMP approach runway 02, private air 451. Yeah, the code, the logo was done by Mr. Stone. He's as well here on the chat, so you have to thank Mr. Stone. I just asked around if somebody was willing to create a logo for me, and he was so nice to do that. So in case that I will make a lot of money with this channel, he will get some royalties. But we have not talked about yet about the percentage. Stone, you won 1 or 2% royalty. Okay, Lucas. Okay, what version of ZeBu are you using? I'm using the latest version and I'm happy. I never had that kind of problem. So, Rattan 10,500. Let's start slowing down. We are reaching the most interesting part of this approach. So we are somewhere here to Rattan. Then we have 9 miles to be at speed 200 at KT532, then reduce 170. And at 530, that's our 170 knots, our final approach point. Have you installed all the latest, all the required Microsoft C++ redistributables? Maybe that is the reason. Okay, plane, what are you doing? Okay. Engine switch. Flight. Okay. Well, continuous should work. Cleared for the RP approach on Visor 2, and we descend according profile, private air 451. I think with the current rate of descent we're doing fine. Look here. We are a bit high for Rattan, but we will be recovering for the final approach point. Well, I suggest you make a new installation of the ZeBu. Maybe just move your current installation copy of the ZeBu to somewhere else, to a backup directory, and just install it from scratch. Maybe it will help. Sometimes things get messed up. Happens. Okay, Kirsten, bis später. Schlaf gut. Oops. Temperature 0, so I need the engine anti-ice at least. So we said 10.5. And then we descend to 8,700. We do it now, after Rattan. You know what? We use the flaps now. Flaps 5 selected because I want to get rid of the speed brakes. Flaps 5 set, speed brakes retracted, and speed brakes aren't. Let's try approach mode. It should give us the final approach course. Yeah, FAC green and glide path armed. And here's the glide path. So we should get that very soon. Hopefully it will turn green. And it captures, or is this our glide path? Could be as well. You know what, we take flaps 10 to increase our rate of descent. And as well we have to reduce our speed to 170. Then gear down. Flap 15. And so at 530 we have to be at 87. Sorry, not here at 87. So this is 530 here with 87. We should make it. We should be okay with the current rate of descent. Yeah, we made it through the layer. Come on, my dear aircraft, give me the glide path. It's not doing it. Although we are at the correct point. VNAV alt green. Alright, then we have to do that now manually here. Do vertical speed green. Why is the plane not following the course? What is it doing? Shit. It's trying to fly me into the mountain. Why doesn't it follow the waypoints? What is this? Ah, scheiße. As they say. Okay, we fly over here. And we go to Dovan direct, and we try LNAV and VNAV and see what it will do now. But it should work with approach mode actually. But this is where the Zeebo obviously has some problems.
1,000 to go.
So we set this to the minimum. Let's take flaps 25. Dirty. And my wife is dirty too. So, come on, descend. No, we're descending, yeah. With the profile. So I would like to see what the plane will do if I now go again to approach. Will it bank right? No, it's still armed. So, there's something wrong with the logic. It can only do straight-in approaches or what? So, 6260 at the next point here, 522, is slightly high. Runway 02 to land, private air 451, thank you. Taxi light on. Clear to land. The next point is 520 at 5280 or above. And we got 3 miles to run. So my plane, why don't you... No, you're doing it correct, yeah? We're just a little bit too high. That's all. And there we are. ...520 was the last point on the approach, then we go basically visual.
1,000 feet stabilized, Mr. Birch, altitude set.
Then we have to fly track 022, and there's the runway, cool, and we are on profile, look at the puppy. Cool. So this worked, but I expected it to work with the approach mode. So autopilot off, auto throttle off. Rev speed, what was it? Oh yeah. NTI is off actually. Rev speed, what was
approaching
it?
Approaching 0.2.
131 watts, I think. Oh no, 140. So we need 145, I'd say. True. Oh yeah. Well, in Germany, puppy is father. Not grandfather, but father. Daddy. Puppy. Daddy. So...
Minimums.
Puppy Sarkozy, yeah? Continue.
200.
Yeah, a little bit low, but I didn't really change my descent angle. Well, whatever. We're fine.
100. 50. 40. 30,
20, 10. Yeah, always kiss it. So manual braking, reverse, deselected, and we take the next exit to the left here. Yeah, but I'm not a profi on the 737, eh? Don't forget, I'm just a bloody business jet driver. I have no ideas about airliners anymore. So, flight time was 54 minutes. Landing lights, strobe lights off, and transponder to alt off, and probe heat off, ignition auto, and runway vacated for private air 451. Taxi stand of your choice.
Probably 451, about to get the new taxi 5 foot short.
Okay, by Foxtrot we taxi to the main apron. Private Air 451, thanks Brody. Yep, and I'll go back working tomorrow, so for me no more ATC this week, sorry.
No worries.
Da stand irgend so eine Rollwegtafel, keine Ahnung. Ist halt Gateway Scenery. So, charts gone, home ground services prepared. We're gonna park next to this Airbus. taxi light off. Oops, a little bit off the center line. Well, come on. So, park brake, chocks, GPU. And then we can connect the GPU before we select fuel to cut off. Oh, hi, hi James. You've been watching as well. Here, the guy is sitting next to me on the apron. This gentleman, he's just texting me that he's been watching us as well on the stream here. And so the EFB is part of the Zeebo. It's a plugin. It's a plugin called AviTab. You see here, AviTab, and it's a plugin for Xplain. Are you using Xplain 2 or are you using Prepared or FSx? Alright, so let's continue this flow here. So beacon off, and oh you're real ATC, very good. Hey, I haven't been to Dubai for a while. I was there last year. I had one flight out of Dubai. Okay, so this AviTab is a freeware plugin for Xplain. So doesn't the PNBG 737 not have a tablet too? I don't know. I never used FSx or Prepared or the PMDG for that one. I jumped right away from FS9 to Xplain 2 years ago, so I have a kind of a gap of knowledge. What do we have here? No, I want to do something. Yeah, but we're still doors, entry open, cargo open, and we want to have the air stairs. There we go. So Mr. Escobar can deplane. I want to have a look at the taxiway sign. Here, this one. Here. That's part of the property. That's showing 3,000 feet of runway remaining. Look. Yeah, 3,000 feet remaining. 2,000 feet remaining. 1,000 feet remaining. 0 feet remaining. That's what it's about. So let's shut down this bird here. La 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 la. So what do I do? So IRS off. Email lights off. Oh, we can terminate the flight. Yeah. Oh, no. Go here. And then we select GPU off and battery off. Silence. We can as well remove the APU to stop the noise. Silence. No, I'm stopping here now. I have some things to do. So I just did two flights. So, and tomorrow or the next few days, hopefully I will go back to real flying, maybe for one or two legs before the and of my career in this company. Sad, sad, sad. Yeah, James, I'm one of the guys with the call sign Fraction. I guess you know us very well. We fly to Dubai every weekend. Yep, exactly. No, in my plane, the Falcon 2000 EX Easy, when we fly any type of LNAV approach with vertical guidance, we select approach and it will basically fly that as well. When you fly, you can try it yourself. When you fly a straight in RNAV or RMP approach to some airport, you can use, now you have, you should use the approach mode. Click on approach and you will see FAC, final approach course, should be armed and then green captured. And the virtual glide path, the GP or glide slope, I think it's GP, the indication, will show armed and then it will capture because it has as well a vertical part of that approach. Normally, not all approaches do, but you know, normally an LNAV, VNAV approach or an RMP approach, they have that. And it works, but I suspect so. Either the Zeebo is not simulating it correctly for curved approaches like this one, or the real plane doesn't do it as well. I don't know. I'm not a 737 pilot, and I'm too lazy to dive into the AFM, the books, to find out. No, the plane had FAC green captured, but it was flying a straight line to the airport. So I suspect either it's a programming, a coding problem with Zeebo or the database, or the real plane as well doesn't do it. Either or. Then when we went back to LNAV, it worked again. But normally you should be able to select approach. Yeah. Well, next time you fly jump seat on a 737-800, ask the crew. They should be able to explain you in detail much better than I can, because I'm not rated on the 737 in whatever form. Yeah. So, guinea pig, do you think it's a good idea to start the ATPL, the PPL during this? Well, if you have the money and you want to fly anyways, then go for the PPL. But if you think you want to do it now to have an advantage, and if you have to borrow money for it now I wouldn't do it. Because if you now do the PPL and you finish after maybe half a year or 1 year, and then you still have to wait another year or two before you can continue because the market is bad and you need money and whatever, then yeah, you have the license, but then again you have to keep it, you have to fly 12 hours to keep it active, or you have to do an examiner flight if you don't do the 12 hours. So there are lots of things happening in the background. You just don't have a license, you know. You have as well, you have to upkeep the license. Yep. Yes, James, well, nice to meet you. Thanks for sending me a message here. But I can just encourage you next time for your next flight, when you go somewhere with a straight in approach with an LNAV, VNAV or RMP approach, try the approach mode. It will work nicely. And as well, you can observe it like you could see it here on your vertical situation display. I think the PMBG 737 has a vertical situation display as well. And you can access it. When you hear Chris, when you push here on the center button several times, you can cycle the modes. Yep. But for a LPV approach or LNAV VNAV approach, you should use the approach mode. So do that or try it. It works. It works nicely. And that's because, and the thing is, if you select it, then you are in a kind of, you know, like an ILS approach, and you can set your target altitude to above your altitude that you currently are, and maybe you are not if you use VNAV. Sometimes it's hanging up. Yeah. So, yeah, the vertical profile is the VSD, vertical situation display, VSD. Yep, guinea pig. Yeah, do that. So, if I were in your shoes, no, I would not borrow money to do that now. No. If you have a job and you save some money, yes, do it. Yep. Well, had I done this approach on my Falcon here, on the Falcon Easy cockpit, it would have been just pass approach, and it would have been LNAV and VPT, whatever it's called. VGP. Yeah. VGP stands for virtual glide path, because there is no glide path signal from the ground, so they renamed it virtual, because it's calculated by the computers with a GPS signal. All right, guys, I need to head out. Thanks for watching. Thanks for interacting. It was nice. And I hope to see you soon again. And yeah, take care. And James, I will add you to my friend list here, so next time I see you, yeah, add friend, and now you are in my list here, so next time I see you I can annoy you a little bit with the chat. Oh yeah, now there are more planes here, or what? Southwest. Are the Philippine guy is still there? The Atlantic is busy as well, today here on Matsum. And Adria is still there, Adria Center, wow. I will fix it later on. And I will share it on our Discord. Alright, I'm heading out. Goodbye, guys. See you.